Hey guys, welcome back to the 7 Steps to Mastering Emotions series. My name is Janie Charlo and I am the author of 7 Steps to Mastering Emotions. Gaining emotional intelligence and getting the best out of life. So get this book. We have already started our series. I have the first video already out, which was on chapter 1, self-mastery. We're going to be going through every single step of this book. So you can get this book on Amazon. You could also go to my website, which is www.nphired.com. That's N as in nurse, P as in practitioner, hired, H-I-R-E-D.com. You could also get the link to the book, and you could also download the ebook as well for easy access. So we are about to start into chapter 2, all right, which is actually the first step. So just to recap, last time we did chapter 1, which was self-mastery, and I left everyone with a few questions about how our thoughts are creating our reality, and how often have you realized that some of the things that you're thinking and some of the things that you're saying is creating your reality. So you really want to catch up on that so that you can follow along. So we are going to go ahead and get into chapter 2, which is actually the first step. And it's actually a very, it's an easy, quick chapter, but it's a powerful chapter and it's an important chapter. And chapter 2 starts with a quote, like all chapters do. And the quote says, "When awareness is brought to an action, power is brought to your life." And that was quoted by Tara Robinson. And that is so important because without awareness, without consciousness, without knowing what we're really doing, without bringing things that which is in the dark to light, we cannot begin to rectify it. So awareness brings about power. So that's very important. All right, chapter 2, step 1, identify your emotions. In order to gain mastery of our emotions, we have to actually identify what we are feeling. Commonly, people go about life feeling things but do not really know why or even the source of their feelings. It is unhealthy and can be quite dangerous to dwell in a space of feelings and emotions and not know why. To help identify emotions, we have to ask ourselves the following questions. What am I feeling right now? Why am I feeling this right now? Is there a root cause to this feeling that I have? It is so important to ask these questions and truly seek the authentic answers within us. Our emotions are always communicating something to us. We just have to attentively listen. And authentic answers is so important, guys, because in order to figure yourself out, you have to be honest with yourself. So you have to ask these questions and truly seek the answers. And you cannot be afraid of what you're going to find. Because sometimes when you ask these questions, you have to be truthful. You know, sometimes, what am I feeling right now? Am I feeling jealousy? Am I feeling, you know, rejection? And sometimes those feelings aren't comfortable. But in order to get to the root cause, you have to be honest with yourself. Let's keep going. The term depression is used very loosely, but is the emotion really depression? Could it be loneliness and not depression? These two emotions can often show up the same way and feel the same way in the body. With the loneliness, we may not want to go out by ourselves. We may just want to stay at home. We may feel like we're alone in the world. But depression can show up the very same way. Sometimes anger shows up and it's really hurt being masked. Truly taking time to identify what emotions we are feeling can be of greatest help in gaining mastery. Without first identifying what we are feeling, we cannot begin to gain mastery over our emotions. So before we can move forward in this book, you have to sit down and identify what you're feeling. So it's important to sit with yourself, go out in nature, get some sun, sit down, take what you're feeling and put it on paper. If you can remember, energy is never destroyed or created. It is only transferred or changed shape. So when you take something that's a thought and you write it down to something that you can see, you've transferred it. You could actually see what's going. And sometimes that helps bring things into perspective. You could see it from a different view. Let's finish up. Do not be afraid of what you may find. Sometimes we identify that we have some repetitive emotional patterns that has been hidden in our blind spots. These repetitive patterns have been leading us either in the direction of the life we desire to create or towards the miscreations and falling just short of what we really want to happen. And I use the word miscreations because in the other video, remember, we are creating our own reality. Whether we are conscious of it or not, we are creating the life that we currently can see manifested. So we're creating every day with the thoughts that we think, with the words that we speak, and with the actions that we take. So I use the word miscreations because sometimes we make mistakes. Sometimes, you know, we set out to do things and it doesn't turn out the way we want it. And that's okay. I like to say it's just a miscreation. We have to figure out how to create it in the way that we want, you know, so that we could see the manifestation that we set out, the vision that we had to set out to see. But either way, identifying your emotions, emotional patterns, and the impact it is currently having on your life is vitally crucial. Identification of emotional blind spots now brings forth that which was hidden to light. So we cannot begin to rectify our life. We cannot change patterns. We cannot change the programming that's currently in our subconscious mind if we cannot first see it and be aware of it. So we have to identify emotional patterns, what we're feeling, everything. So step one is identification. So I leave you with the task of sitting with yourself, seeing what you are really, really feeling. You know, are you angry often? Are you getting upset because your order through the drive-thru was wrong? Are you in traffic and you're upset? Are you snapping at your children too much? Are you yelling at your kids? Is it anxiety or is it stress? Are you overworked? Are you depressed? Are you really lonely because you're not getting the connection you really desire? Because things can seem a lot like something and it's really not. So step one is identify your emotions. We cannot go a step further in this series, and you cannot apply everything going further without first identifying your emotions. So take this time. The next video will be coming out, but between now and then, identify your emotions. And in order to do that, you have to tap in. You have to go within yourself. No one else can help you identify what you're feeling because only you know that. And the other most important thing is be honest with what you're really feeling. Are you looking out at the creations of someone else, someone that is looking out at the success of someone else's life and wanting that for yourself? And when you do that, how does that make you feel? Do you feel lack? Do you feel envy? Do you feel jealousy? Be honest with yourself, because until you can truly be honest and authentic with what you're really, really feeling, you cannot begin to rectify it. So that was chapter 2, which was step 1, identify your emotions, all right? And so it's a really quick chapter, but it's a very vitally crucial chapter and is the foundation of every other step that we're going to build on. So again, guys, Janie Charlotte, author of 7 Steps to Mastering Emotions. This is the 7 Steps to Mastering Emotions series. Catch up on all the videos because we're going to break it all down. Take care, and I will see you next time. And until then, I wish you guys lots of love, light, peace, happiness, and a life of all the creations and desires that you want to happen. Take care.